Since I knew Father was able to get away, it was safest to just surrender. I'm coming out. I'm surrendering.
Get down the fucking stairs then.
Yes.
Fucking stairs, let's go.
Yes. Don't worry, my hands are up. I will not do anything sketchy. What the fuck did I get myself into? Brother Sterling and I seem to have been captured by Quaid and his group and what seems to be the Chedakis.
So, now you wish to tell me your real name?
My name is Eddy.
Eddy.
But I only lied to you because I'm afraid people want us dead for some really weird reason. I don't know why. I didn't do nothing wrong to anybody. And I'm just trying to protect myself, that's all. Nothing personal, I swear. During this time, Brother Kyle and Brother Nez were keeping an eye on us.
Alright. Elliot, come on, take the hostages up the hill.
Go keep them company, there's apparently assholes shooting at us.
Hope they're not your friends.
Quite frankly, Eddie, I hope they are, because maybe they can get us out of this mess. Well, that sounds like a rather loud shot.
Unfortunately, they couldn't stop at all, but fortunately, my brothers were able to get away.
Okay. Anyways, alright, we're going to go for a little jog. I'm going to just take a look at things. Sorry for the inconvenience, gentlemen. Yeah, that's what happens when you try to take our guy.
Oh, I think the man was unfortunately taken. There was this incident over the hill. And at the same time, your man came into the compound, so I do believe it was a misunderstanding.
This is what we are going to do now, okay? I'm going to undo your binds, okay? Now, I know you guys don't have any weapons on you, which is good. Now, if anybody decides to get the bright idea and run away, then I'm going to take that as an act of hostility against us, and we will end your life.
Understood.
You understand? It is rather shady under here, and nice clear cover from the sun.
Of course, but we don't know if there's anybody else here. Mr. Elliot, just double check, make sure you got all the radios, don't want anything hidden. Just, you know, I'm a person that likes to rather be safe than sorry.
Do you feel good about this, studio? I was the one that let you go. I was not the one that captured you, so I think you by you threatening me.
Okay.
The fact that you pointed a gun at my face. I didn't like that.
I didn't have any bullets in the gun, I'll tell you that much. Sorry, I'm sorry if you pissed your pants a little bit.
This is what we're gonna do. You guys are going to walk toward me in a single file line.
I'm so sorry for having lied to you.
Okay.
Alright, liar. Stand in front of me and your friend can stand right behind you. Okay, don't try anything fucking stupid.
First you tell us not to be wise guys, then you tell us not to be stupid. I'm not really sure what to do.
Oh, please,
well,
Sterling.
Don't be a smart
ass. You're being a fucking wise guy right now.
Come on, follow me. Okay. Alright, stop right here.
Yes.
Stop right here. Okay. You, with the black bandana, you go up against this tree right here. Somebody watch him, shoot him if he runs. Okay, and Eddy. Does anybody have a knife I could borrow?
You might have to take a seat.
You can borrow mine. Might be a little sweaty, but it'll do the job.
Believe it or not, but Brother Kyle and Brother Naz were still hot on our trail.
Okay. Do you know that I used to be a doctor, right? Did I ever tell you about that?
I've heard of you.
Something I always find fascinating. It's about the human body and how much trauma it can actually suffer before it goes into shock and eventually dies, right?
I did some research, extensive research, and I was told that it takes the human body an average between 5 and 6 minutes to bleed out to the point where there's no blood left in the body and they die.
Okay.
Okay, so now we're going to ask the question again. You were in Saroy for what reason? You have about 4 or 5 minutes before you fucking die, so I'm not going to fix you up until you tell me everything that I need to know.
I initially was in Saroy, but really was looking for a bed first, and then
4 minutes and 45 seconds.
My friends came by.
Who are your friends?
Sterling over there and others. We were, I don't know, six or seven.
Some kind of ceremony. Come on.
Speak the truth, Eddy.
You're fucking dead.
And then we met a man, and he didn't believe in us. And what we believe in.
15 seconds until you fucking die.
And so we helped. We tried to help him believe. That's all we did. We didn't hurt him. I swear to God.
So you motherfuckers tried to force your little sick, perverse beliefs on other people. That's exactly what he told me when I saw him.
Yeah.
Well, so what do you believe in, hmm? Are you one of those, praise the what? What is it? Oh, come on. Tell me!
The Maker.
Good.
Yeah. Not feeling too good.
Here, bandages.
Okay.
Are we gonna have fun with this guy, too? What about this guy?
Do you know who Thomas Jones is?
Yes. Only the guy that took the pills away from me.
Hmm?
Okay. I used to be a part of the family. Have you ever heard of them before? Do you know what they did? Answer.
No, sir, I don't.
They started off as a little peaceful group, and then all of a sudden it escalated to forcing people to partake in ceremonies.
Then, once that stopped working, they started getting more violent.
They started cutting, marking, torturing, tormenting people. That's the kind of sick fucks that you are involved in.
Okay? Now, we came to Saroy because one of my friends was forced to partake in your little fucking cult. So I came to Saroy to question, and you guys just ran right past me like a bunch of assholes.
And in turn, made me run all over this goddamn country like an asshole. Until finally we spotted you here. We surrounded the place, and then you guys pointed weapons at my friends and told them and tried to disarm them. So then we started shooting.
And now we're here. So how do we go past this? I mean,
It would probably be easier based on past experiences, because if we have learned anything in life, the past will dictate the future, right? Those who repeat the past are condemned to make the same mistakes. Isn't that how the old saying goes? So I see you two fuckheads doing the same thing with your little cult and your little false prophet father, implanting lies into your little weak minds. So my good conscience would tell me that this is happening all over again, and I should just put a bullet in your head, and I should put a bullet in your head, and just call it a fucking day. And this maker bullshit from that bastard father who's manipulating you so you can be his little slaves, you guys are falling right into the trap, hook, line, and sinker, my friend. You are down a path that's only going to lead to your eventual demise.
Just like you say, I've seen firsthand what this father of yours and his people have done. And I've done some bad shit back in war, but there's nothing compared to what you fucks have done to people. You're lucky you're still fucking alive. I don't know why I haven't put bullets in your head yet. Really hard to keep finger off trigger.
I thank you for that. I thank you for that. I really do. Listen, I wasn't there in the past. I was just lost. I'm just nothing but a weak fucking piece of shit. That's what I am.
There's no fucking answers. It just gets worse for you. Look, if you were never with them, this never would have happened to you. Now look, you might fucking die because of it.
No, I don't want to die.
The father takes people like you that are down on their luck and uses that to manipulate them. Listen, you seem like a very reasonable person, and I think deep down inside that beating heart of yours, I think you're actually a nice guy. Who is kind of fell upon the shit end of the stick in life, right? You know, someone just like me, maybe, who, you know, just doesn't get a chance with other people. People look at you like you're a fucking disease.
I know. All the fucking time.
Yes.
Everyone leaves me. Every time. But they didn't leave me. They seem to care for me. And they really do.
They're using you.
They picked you because you are who you are. That is why they picked you.
Everyone abandons me all the time. What's to say you people wouldn't abandon me? Everybody thinks I'm a disease, like I'm a piece of shit.
Okay.
I was really scared, but luckily I had my brothers looking out for me.
Okay, Eddy. Now, I'm going to ask you a series of questions. Remember that little exercise that we did where it involved my knife and seeing how long it would take you to bleed out?
Yes.
Okay. Now, I am more than happy to continue that experiment if need be, but I think that you are smart enough to just answer my questions without any more violence and blood. So, when I saw you in Dolina with the Earth two people, who were they, and were they really your friends? Now be honest, because if I catch you in the lie, I'm going to slit your throat.
Eddy, it's not worth holding on to.
I know.
Okay, names.
Caroline. And Kyle.
Caroline, good. And Kyle.
What was Kyle's last name?
It's
Liam. His real name is Liam.
I really don't know.
He told me his real name when I was in lecture.
He told us his name is Kyle.
We have information about Kyle Sweeney. We've heard from some of our sources.
That is a different man.
He wears these like cargo shorts or these weird looking shorts.
Yes.
And he talks all nervous and whatnot.
He said his name was Kyle.
Wow, your own family are lying to you.
I hope you do something about that, Eddy.
And now you are here because of that. More liars. More people betraying you.
Sterling, why would he lie to us?
Alright, enough with the emotional setback. Who else? Let me motivate you. I need some names.
No need to hurt me.
People.
I'll talk. There's Nez.
Well, Sterling here, and then I told you Caroline and Kyle, and then there's Kyle Sweeney as well.
There's so many. I can't think. There's another girl. Yeah, she's a sister. I haven't met her. I just heard of her.
Sister Lucia, she is...
I haven't met everyone. I really haven't met everyone. Okay.
It's obviously breaking your concentration. Maybe the barrel of my gun to the back of your head will jog your memory a little bit better.
Oh, no, please. I don't know. I haven't met everyone. The father said he was arranging a meeting soon, and we were going to meet all our brothers and sisters. And
where?
We don't know yet. He was about to arrange that. All of a sudden, brothers Liam and Nez took action.
What locations do you guys hang out at?
Who's shooting? What's going on?
Get down.
What's going on?
Are you alright? Okay.
I'm okay, Sterling. That man looks hurt. Shit. What the fuck did we get into? What is this shit? This is not what I was promised.
Have you been hit?
No, I'm good.
You settle down. Have you been hit?
I'm good. Come on, Eddie, you let me out. Let me play. I could get you out of this. They took a couple of guys down, but they couldn't save us. Luckily, though, Brother Nez and Brother Kyle, now known as Liam, got away. I'm not too sure where Quaid and his guys were trying to take us, but we were now landed in Gorka. Been walking forever.
We're going to go to a special place, and you each get to choose where your remains will be buried. How exciting is that?
What?
Yeah. Come on, keep up. Enjoy the last minutes of your life.
I didn't do anything wrong to you.
There's nothing to worry about, Eddie.
You ever hear the expression, you reap what you sow?
But we haven't sown anything yet, Quaid.
No, come on, you hate yourself, right?
Fine, then let Eddie go. Take me, let him go.
Oh, Sterling.
He was about to kill himself. I'm just finishing the job for him.
Does anyone have a shovel so we can dig him some shallow graves?
I'm taking over this ship now. No, please, no. No, don't.
Hell, we can make them dig their own grave.
And you just fucking stay up there.
How does it feel? Like, right now, at this moment, knowing in the next couple of minutes you're going to no longer be on this planet, how does it feel? Are you nervous, scared, worried?
I can't wait! Shut up! Shut up! You fucking piece of shit! Just do it, Eddie. Just fucking do it. You know what? Save him the fucking trouble. Just do it yourself. Fuck you, you fucking... So what's your deal? Huh? Now explain to me, what's your deal? So what's up with you? Why are you going around deciding for everybody, huh?
There's a certain set of principles and ideals that I follow closely. You see, when all this, collapse happened, I saw the opportunity. I saw the promise.
Yeah, I get you.
you know? No government, nobody in suits telling you what to do, how to breathe.
Yeah. See, Eddie's a little weak. He seems to not be able to do things on his own. I try to fucking make him realize, you know? Doesn't seem to be doing much for him. So I have to take over here for a little minute and explain to you that this little weak bitch, you know, he's not gonna do much for himself, I understand that, but maybe I can reason with him, you know? Because I kind of like you, I understand your whole point of freedom.
So why did Eddie want to kill himself before? Because nobody liked him? Because
he's afraid of me? That's why. He's fucking weak. Doesn't want to do shit right. Trying to teach him how to survive. How to be a real fucking man for once. This guy can't even pick up a fucking lady, can you believe it? Fuck. I just want to fuck one, you know? But no, Eddie, no, he just can't handle it.
Yeah, you know, you gotta enjoy the little things, right?
Right? Jesus Christ.
This meeting he was talking about, though, with all the you remember.
Yeah, honestly, boys, if it could mean my life, I would tell you instantly. I really would. But, looks like, that father guy never said anything about anything. He just said there will be a meeting, my son. Yes, my children, all that fucking yada yada.
I wish I could help you.
Anything else I can do that perhaps may spare my life? Anything. Seriously.
Well, let's see. If, I allowed you to live, would you, beat this man to a pulp?
This guy?
This is a great idea. I was thinking the same thing myself. Make them fight for it.
Interesting.
Wonder how Eddie would feel about that. sorry, I make myself laugh sometimes. I was right back where it all started, in Altar. I didn't want to kill Brother Sterling, so I kept trying to fight my way out. Okay. Oh, this is where the irony. You see this? Right here. I believe it's this spot right here. A man called Quinn Bauer was buried. Yeah, Eddie's a really good friend, actually. His last friend before he met all these guys and stuff.
Okay. Alright. So, Mr. Eddie, would you take a knee?
Sure. Is this about killing me, or do I still have an option here?
Fight him to the death, and if you win, you get to keep your life.
Don't do it! Fuck out! Stay the fuck out! Don't even try!
Don't do it!
Don't even try.
Okay, so you're gonna help us with the father, then. So then he is useless, right?
I could do my best, yeah. And, like I said, yeah, he's pretty useless to me, too. No, stop it!
Get the fuck out!
Don't even try. Alright? I wanna fucking live. You don't. Not my fucking problem!
I can tie him up unless you use my axe.
Oh, an axe? Maybe? Don't do it! Get the fuck out! Alright? Yeah. Yeah. Alright, yeah, I'll do that. Then I'll help you. I'll fucking help.
I'll help you with the father. Fuck this guy. If you need intel, I've got it.
Okay, now we're talking.
I owe them nothing.
Good. Bravo.
Hello?
Okay. Looks like you've been replaced.
Your indecision caused a decision for you, so to speak.
Yeah, you got knocked the fuck out.
Things are still a little blurry. Who the fuck knocked me out?
No, your friend. Her friend did, yeah. Go up against this rock. Right here, Eddie. Your friend decided to,
perhaps you could just cast him aside.
You want, I guess.
Yeah, you want something?
Get up.
How about you have two?
No, get back to the rock, come on. This is where,
Aren't two heads better than one?
This is where I finish Eddie's work.
I'll make him an outcast.
Okay, ready?
Please don't kill me! Stay the fuck out, Eddie! Please don't, I've never done anything wrong.
Okay. Stay out, you fucking weak.
Ready? One, two.
Shit!
Oh, no. fuck, I forgot to put ammo in my gun. How unfortunate.
I bet you pissed his pants.
Fucking shit. I never hurt anyone.
Yeah. Okay, that's why I didn't kill you. Calm the fuck down. Now, I will kill somebody if you guys decide not to help. You were very, quick to help us with the father. I wonder why. What are you going to do, and how can I trust you?
I don't believe he is the way for the Maker's Path.
I just do not believe that the father is the one to lead.
It seems like it was peaceful to begin with, and it gets corrupted easily, because there's control.
Yeah.
If I would have known all this fucking shit...
You think the man in charge, both times when Mr. Quaid knew them and now when we know them, you think maybe there's a common denominator to why shit's going bad?
Right now, as it stands, and to kill us both, and they're gone. They're down the rabbit hole. We'll never see them again.
You let us both return. You let us both return. We say nothing. I will feed you the information you desire.
My group and Mr. Quaid's group have found you plenty of times without you two. You guys are fucking shit on shoe, in my opinion.
But you have never found the father, have you?
He always runs away and lets his horn.
Yes, he gets away. He gets away from you. What if we can lead you right to him?
Well, now I'm listening, but what choice do we have if you're going to try to double cross us and we just do ambush?
Because we don't want to die.
I mean, Lily did see the father, Novi, that one time, where we saw them and they all ran off like a bunch of little scared cockroaches when we showed up.
Ran away.
Siren.
Hi. It blows my fucking mind.
It's oddly, strangely good to see you.
Mr. Chedaki, man. If your friends were getting shot at, would you run away like a coward, or would you die with them?
Me it! We stand and fight where we are.
Exactly. None of us ran during this little...
I will tell you this, Quaid, when we were in Staroy, I did not want to run.
My mind plays tricks on me.
The father chose to run.
If I would have known, Siren, I would have never, ever...
Fucking coward.
Beginning to believe this.
Guys, every time you guys fight, he runs and leaves all of you to die. What kind of father is that? What if their sons and daughters die?
I'm ready.
That's what friendship's all about.
Yes, Siren.
Get him.
Anything for you?
Yeah,
you were so kind to me.
I could not offer you many assurances, but I can tell you this. I have a background in being able to stay undercover. If you send me back, I will do as you say. But I want some assurances that I will give you the father, but there are others that I would like you to spare. Others I feel like I can sway to be better people.
Here's my deal, and I'm not speaking on behalf of the Chedaki, because they make their own deals. But I'll tell you this, you deliver the father in a nice little gift-wrapped box, then I will honor my part of the bargain and leave your friends that you pick alone. Because they are, after all, just a bunch of mindless brainwashers.
I will extend this on behalf of the Chedaki. If you deliver us the father,
it's not really all that
as long
bad,
as one of your friends take up arms against us,
father told me to embrace him.
Do not go trying to spread this little religion of yours to anybody who is not willing.
Here's my guarantee, okay? If you decide to backstab us, I will guarantee, and I'm a very resourceful man, the Chedaki are very resourceful people, we will find you and hunt you down like dogs every fucking day.
I have no doubt about this.
Until all of you are completely wiped out.
Okay. Sounds good.
Thing. You are going to deliver him a message on behalf of Connor and Paul of the Chedaki. They know he is best. They are waiting. They are watching. And they will have him.
I do not believe that is a wise decision. You could just deliver it to him yourself when he's here.
Believe me, If he is what the man I think he is, he already knows. It does not matter.
You can make it happen.
I'm sure you'll figure out the way to...
We will make it happen.
This is non-negotiable here, gentlemen.
And we understand.
We're negotiating these terms.
And there's no way we will try to even negotiate that, Quaid. We won't. We'll do as you say. I want to fucking live, man. Alright? And so far, you've been telling me some stuff, and I'm really starting to fucking doubt some shit here. So I'm ready to do as you say, because I want to live. I was going to kill myself, yes. Right? But I turned back on that decision, right? Because I'm right here in front of you, am I not?
Yeah, you are.
Okay. Yeah, so, I really want to live.
Figure it out.
We'll do our best, Quaid.